Good morning and all.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Professor Ping Hui Paj.
And who do we have in the studio today?
Dr. Paj Pajpati.
Wonderful. Dr. Paj Pajpati, what is the problem here and all?
Well, don't you ask yourself this question.
What is the question?
How many dimensions can you fit into the internet?
How many dimensions can you fit into the internet?
Yes. How many? One, two, three, four.
How many do you think, doctor?
Well, I don't know. It is a question I'm asking.
You're asking? Oh, you're asking me, Professor.
I'm asking the world. How many dimensions can you fit into the internet?
I would say very many and all. Because how about this?
What would the dimensions be like?
Doctor, are you asking? What a big question here and all. And it's taking me by surprise. I have no immediate response. But
I know, it needs a little bit of contemplation.
As with all things, doctor, we need the contemplation. For the party plants to grow.
I think you stop laughing. It used to make me laugh a lot. I don't know why.
How many dimensions you can fit into the internet? Now, how many do you fit into a memory stick?
Oh, I don't know.
Because
the problem is you're carrying it around in your pocket.
All these dimensions.
That's right.
Do you think maybe people don't know how many dimensions they're interacting with when they are on Facebook?
True. There's many dimensions. And why is there only the Facebook? Why not the lead book? Why not the earbook? Why not the mouth book? No, only the Facebook.
Do you think that's being...
I think it's limiting.
Limiting, restrictive.
Because why are we only looking at the face?
Yeah. Spirit book.
Spirit book or heart book? No?
Yeah.
Just look at the heart, look at the face.
Yeah, pretty much so. They think it's misleading. Millions of people, they think Facebook, look at the face. And all this time, we are not seeing the heart of it.
No. And what's the book in the heart? Because the heart is a big book. Is it not?
You know, doctor, you're very right.
Lots of pages.
Many stories.
Lots of dimensions.
Yes, but put the dimensions in order. You say, how many dimensions can you fit into the internet? I would say more than 300.
I would agree that more than 300, I think it could be an infinite amount of dimensions. Infinite.
Right, we've had a very nice steam cake. Time. Now we want to discuss something very controversial because we're finding people's minds are stagnating and their hearts. What could stimulate humanity to shoot to the next level of enlightenment?
Well, that's a very, very good question, Professor Ping Shri. Isn't that your name? I don't know what your name is. Sorry about that.
It's all right, very close.
But you know.
Professor's good.
Yeah.
Keep it simple.
Okay, professor. Okay, I don't know. Let me think about it for a minute.
What is the question?
How going to the next level?
Yes, how do we take 50 million people and let them feel the next level of evolution? Because, you know...
I think they have to remember that they are human. I think they have to remember that they are.
Ah, very good, you know. Sometimes days, because they are in the internet with so many dimensions, they forget they're on Earth.
Dimension.
Too many dimensions. Confusion.
Yes. An infinite amount of dimensions. The internet becomes the infinite. Infinite.
Well, doctor, it's very profound and all. I find your humor contagious too. It must be your joy. Doctor.
Because you know, I think that everybody has the power to do what they they can do to be in Earth Convention and make it a very, very beautiful place.
Very, very nice place.
Very beautiful.
Yeah. Some were saying, you know, like, Nirvana comes to Earth, or Earth is Nirvana. You know, we just like, would you litter in Nirvana?
And I litter in Nirvana? No. No.
Then why did
I litter in Nirvana? I'm going to be stepping in my own gut.
Yeah.
I'm not going to be doing that.
No littering in Nirvana. Now why litter in Earth? What do you say to people who litter in Nirvana?
Who litter in Nirvana? Oh, I think they must just
pick it up.
Pick it up, and they must just think about where they're going to put it and what happens to it when they're going to put it where they're going to put it.
Yeah, very, very good.
No, because they might find they step on it, or they eat it, or they breathe it, or a friend of theirs might touch it, or eat it, or breathe it, or
the
pet cat might.
The black cat.
The pet cat, or their pet dog.
Or the pet.
They don't know who's gonna touch that after they drop it. Who?
Hmm.
Maybe it's gonna go into the sea, it's gonna have a long journey, find its way to
Antarctica.
Ireland. And then what happens when it gets to Ireland?
Then some other one is gonna pick it up.
Maybe the dog will be running along the beach after it's stick, and it'll pick up the rubbish too.
Is there another infinite journey?
It's an infinite
journey.
Impendent.
No, now Professor Doctor, I'm talking to myself. I was thinking of a very, very big question and all. In Africa, you ever been there?
On a multi-dimensional level, yes.
Yeah, me too, you know. They say it's a very nice place.
Africa.
Yeah.
It's a very, very, very nice place. Very nice.
They say something.
It's where we come from.
Very old and powerful.
Very
old. And they think maybe the people in the world should respect it. In fact, it is not a 3-star country, it's a 6-star country.
I think they must know that it is like old bones.
Africa is like old bones,
yes,
Doctor.
It's your old bones. It's your skeleton from long, long time ago.
Long?
Long, long time ago. These were the bones. Africa was the bones, the rocks with the bones.
Yeah, I feel it in my bones. I was African.
Oh, I see, Professor. I see you have some other personality that wants to come out.
There was something there.
I think.
It was French stamping, you know. Excuse me. You know, we've got to be multidimensional and all. That's what we're talking about. So if another dimension is coming to talk to you, then you must let it happen.
Okay.
I'll
do that. When it comes, I'll do that. So, what do you think, Professor?
About what?
About the Rita. About the things you find on your path.
I think everyone must pick it up. I think they're littering in Nirvana. And I think they must pick it up. Because...
Why do you think they don't pick it up?
I think maybe they've got some mental blockage that prevents them from seeing that the Earth is like their very own Nirvana.
It's like their backyard. It is their backyard.
Yeah, they're very, the whole big thing.
You don't litter your backyard.
No. No. I very much hope so not and all. So they must pick it up and they must take care not to make it in the first place.
Yes. But you see a problem. The problem is plastic.
Plastic
is a problem. Really, it is. I think it's a problem.
It's very much
it's in everything. Everything you go to take something like a donut and you find there's a lot of plastic. You go to buy some toilet paper, you find it's wrapped in plastic.
Soon, babies will come out wrapped in plastic.
I hope not.
I hope not. Doctor, we hope never to encounter a baby coming out wrapped in plastic.
No, I like to not have a plastic dimension.
Yeah.
It was not a dimension I'd like to see in the infinite dimensions. I'm really dropping my saliva, sorry.
gonna cut here for a quick break. Thank you for listening and all.